Okay, guys, welcome. One more class. Let's see if I can get this game. I have a game ready for you. 1 second, please. We don't have Ruby. How are you today, Ruby?
Good, teacher.
Good. What did you do today? What did you do today? What were your activities today?
Nothing. In house.
Nothing?
Homework. Just
homework.
More homework. Today?
The school?
Yes, the university.
Well, you were in school then. You said nothing. You were in school. Excellent. Stefania. Hello, Stefania.
Yes, teacher.
Good to see you back. What happened? It's been a while.
Entró una llamada, teacher.
When? ¿Cuándo?
Ah, ahorita.
Oh, no, no. What I mean, I haven't seen you in a while. No te había visto.
Ok. Ayer me perdí por lo del que se cayó el WhatsApp y el Facebook. Me perdí así como que no supe.
Oh.
Y ya creo que saqué, pero iban a ser las 7.
Ajá, sí, ya. You text me about that. Yeah, I know WhatsApp, all the social media, but no Zoom. No Zoom. Unlucky we have a class yesterday. Good. So what did you do yesterday, Estefania, besides that?
I see movies. I watch TV.
You saw movies? Yes.
Yes, I clean my house all the day.
Okay, all day long. Are you also in San Marcos or where are you, Estefania? Where do you live?
No, Acapulco.
Ah, Acapulco. Where? What day was it?
I live in Mocimba.
Ah, Mocimba. Okay. Good, good. Julio. Mr. Cortez.
Hello, teacher.
Hello, hello. How are you today, Julio?
Good.
Good.
Yes.
You sound very sure. Good. Okay. What did you do today? What activities did you do today?
Homework. Do homework. Yeah, not my.
That's it. You didn't eat, you didn't watch TV, you didn't shower.
Nada.
No, nada? Really?
Yes.
Okay. We're just checking your oral expression. Remember, you have to do a little bit more. Let me see if you understand this question. We're going to play something here. Okay. Open your Kahoot, please. Kahoot.com. It's loading. Give me 1 second. Okay, give me 1 second and give me the game pin. Okay, we're going to work on this, your emotion. Try to answer whatever you can do. Si no entienden la pregunta que se les hace, nada más traten de no adivinar, pero la que sienta que es la correcta. So we're going to work with emotions, feelings. Okay, loading the game team. You have it there, 754-8655. Open your Kahoot, please, with this. Play, then the game pin, and then your name. Easy, easy. Just waiting for you. ¿Has jugado Kahoot, verdad? Oh, no. Estefanía, yes, it's right there.
No.
No.
Ah, well, vamos a jugar. Abran Kahoot.com en su browser, el Google o el que tengan. Se va donde dice play o jugar y le van a dar el número de PIN. Okay. Just waiting for Ruby and Julio. Julio is right there. Waiting for Ruby.
Moment, please, teacher.
Yeah, I'm waiting for you. No worries. Okay. Yes. Excellent. Yes. Let's learn about emotions with the characters from the movie Inside Out. Look at the picture. Look at the picture. This character is always trying to bring positive and happy moments to Riley's life. What emotions does she represent? Sadness, look at the picture. Joy, anger, disgust. Joy is this character feels blue and emotionally fragile. What emotions does she represent? Fear, sadness, anger, or joy? Just look at the picture. Sadness, yes. Riley doesn't like broccoli on pizza. What emotion is this causing? Fear, imagination, taste, or disgust? Yes, disgust. But dreams can sometimes be scary, but can protect us from unsafe situations. You gotta guess, is fear or is courage? Fear or courage? Uno es miedo y el otro es coraje. Fear and courage. Fear. Okay. When her parents asked her so many questions at dinner, Riley erupted in. Look at the picture. Anger, joy, fear, or sadness. Yes, anger. Yes. Remember, anger, coraje, joy, felicidad, fear, miedo, sadness, tristeza. Good. All right, true or false? All emotions have an important role in our lives. True or false? Yes, true. Okay, we have this one. Use this just for reading. Ruby, can you read this, please? Here.
Emotions are a normal part of life, understanding what were friendly and expressing those friendly in heavenly ways is an important part of growing up. Mucho no sé cómo
yeah. Growing up. Growing up. Yeah, growing up. Yes, excellent.
Growing up.
Yes, emotions are a normal part of life. Understanding what we're feeling and expressing those feelings in healthy ways is an important part of growing up. Just two more questions. Okay, let's keep this one, please. All right, well, please, Julio. Estefania, second place, and Ruby, of course, first place, gold medal. Ruby, excellent. Okay, that was just a little exercise. Let's remember what we have, where we started this week. Hold on, please. All right, we start with unit 3. As you know, we have 4 lessons. We start talking about favorite people, celebrities, some extra exercises. We have grammar too. We were talking about possessive. We reach lesson B, people we know. We learn some new adjectives to describe someone. Okay. So we learn how to describe someone's personality. Remember, not physical, personality. We have these exercises yesterday. We were talking about family and numbers. And we have this exercise for you. Remember we were talking about Erica's grandparents? Well, we have another exercise about Erica's grandparents. Okay, you need to complete here. 1, 2, 3, 4. One, you already have who's the man in the photo? You have to answer, to ask and answer. Okay, number one is already solved, it's who's. So you need to guess what's number two. What's number two?
What?
What's his name, his wife's name? Yes, excellent, good job. Okay. Number three. You have the question there. Erica's grandparents, 70, 75?
How old?
Yes, well, let's say how old? How old? Number four. Julio, what do you think? Number four.
Number four is where?
Yes. Where are they from originally? Yes. Right? Okay, you have completed the exercise. Then ask and answer the questions with a partner. Let's do it in team, please. Okay, Ruby asks Julio, Julio asks Estefania. Let's practice. Well, we have Christian here. You can check the answers here, or you can take a picture so you can practice with your partner. Just wait for Christian, so it can be two teams.
Hello, teacher.
Hello. Okay, Christian, you're going to work. We're going to work on this exercise, please. This is already complete. Just make the questions and answer. You have four questions, okay?
Okay.
Go ahead, please. Okay, hello Miriam. Miriam.
Hi. Hi teacher.
Okay, well, you were signing in and signing out. You have problems with the internet, I guess. So we were doing this exercise. Remember, let's read it. Remember number three, you have some problems to pronounce how old. Those are very basic words. For example, let's do it one more time. What's his wife's name? How old is Erica's grandparents? Well, here it's grandparents. Hold on. Remember, if you ask in plural, because they are talking about two people, how old? No, how old are Erica's grandparents? Grandparents is plural. So what are they from original? Yes. So try to practice, please. I mean, verbally practice. Miriam, do you have a chance to practice? ¿Sí practicaste o no?
He estado practicando un poquitín, pero no, porque no sé qué tema es.
Estefanía, who's the man in the photo?
He is my grandpa.
Is your grandpa? Who is Erika's grandpa?
It's Erika's grandpa.
Okay, good. All right. Ruby, what's his wife's name?
His name is Angela.
Yeah, her name is Angela. Her.
Her name is Angela.
You can say it's Angela. You have the two options. Number three, Christian, how old are Erica's grandparents?
His grandpa 78 and grandma 72.
Yes, grandpa is 78 years old and grandma is 72 years old. Excellent. Julio, number four, where are they from original? Julio.
Yes, they from Texas.
They're from Texas, excellent. All right, finally we have the grammar here. The grammar is very important, as well as the context. So please pay attention. We are going to talk about information questions with be. When we say information questions, these are information questions. Why? Because we need information on this. These are some, not all of them. Where, what, who, how old, how, etc. We have many more, like which, right? We have when. So please try to pay attention when you use you. Remember, when you use you, it's because you are using are. If you use the singular, like he, she, or it, you use is. With they, you also use are, it's plural. Okay, remember, you could be singular or plural, depending, but we use the same are. Please pay attention.
Page 27, 3, grammar, information questions with be. You.
How are you? I'm fine. Where are you from? I'm from Florida. How old are you? I'm 23.
He, she, it.
Who's this? It's my grandmother. Where's she from? She's from Texas. What's she like? She's very smart.
They.
How are your parents? They're fine, thanks. Where are they today? They're at home. What are their names? Their names are Linda and Carlos.
Okay, excellent. Let's read, please. Give me 1 second. Let me mark here. Okay, Miriam, you read here. Stefania, you read here. And Julio, you read here, please. Let me change the color here.
You say you. How are you? I'm fine. Where are you from? I'm from Florida. How old are you? I'm 23.
Okay.
He, she, and it. Who's this? It's my grandmother. Where is she from? She's from Texas. What's she like? She's very smart.
Yes, pay attention on this. Who's this? So we answer with it. It's my grandmother. And here in these two questions, where and what, we are asking with she. Where is she from? Where is she from? We are using a contraction. Means like, where is she from, right? She's from Texas. She's from Texas. What's she like? In this one, what's she like? We are asking for information about her personality. She's very smart. Julio?
Yes. Hey. How are your parents? They're fine. Fine. Thank you. Thanks. Where are they today? They're at home. What are their names? Their names are Linda and Carlos.
Yes. Okay. So Pat, the same with they, plural. How are your parents? Your parents. So is the answer is with they. They're fine. Thanks. Why is plural? ¿Cómo están tus padres? They're fine. Thanks. Where are they today? They're at home. Good. I don't know if you have any questions about the grammar, the construction with information questions like this. ¿Sí le están entendiendo la gramática de aquí? Por ejemplo, aquí en las information questions siempre va primero el informe. Eso ya lo hicimos a una actividad. But information questions, ya sea how, where, how old, etc., who. Luego sigue verbo to be, because we are using verb be here. And then the subject, the pronoun. In this case, for example, is you. How are you? I'm fine. That is the pattern. Again, where, then verb be, and then the subject. Where are you from? Remember in this one, from is at the end. How old are you? Same pattern, are you, verb be. Okay? You answer with the same, verb be. I'm 23. When you ask with singular nouns, singular pronouns, he, you, it, like where, what, right? We are asking with she, where's she from? She's from Texas. What's she like? She's very smart. On this one, who's this? We respond with it, okay? Questions, preguntas about this?
No, teacher.
Julio, Estefania, Miriam?
No, teacher.
Christian?
No.
Que recuerden de preguntar, ¿eh? De preguntar y no se queden con la duda. La cuestión es practicar mucho, practicar y practicar. Para poder llegar al objetivo, que es este, el manejo de estos del verbo to be es básico, claro. Next exercise, we are going to unscramble. These are scramble means ponerlos en una misma secuencia, en un orden. Like this one. You are present how, so it's how are your parents? Okay, let's ask an answer. Compare with your partner. Okay, let's do it in teams, please. Yes? Yes?
Yes.
Okay. Hold on, please. Go ahead, please. Okay, guys, let's continue, please. We have Julio, Stefania, and Miriam. Let's wait for Christian and Ruby. See what you have. Yes, I think you're here. Okay. And first one on my screen is Julio. What do you have in number two, Julio?
Yes, Gil. What are your parents' names?
Good, thank you. Estefania, please, number three.
How old is your father?
How old is your father? Good, good job, excellent. Number four, Miriam.
Yes, what's your like mother?
No. Remember, like is at the end.
What's your mother like?
Yes. Why? Because we are asking a description, personality description. Yes, good. Thank you. Number five, Ruby.
Where is your mother today?
Yes. Number six, Christian.
Where are your grandparents from?
Yes. Where are your from is always at the end when we have these kind of questions, right? Okay, number seven. Julio, what do you have in number seven?
Who's your favorite uncle? How se pronuncia?
Who's your favorite aunt? Aunt. It's like la un poquito medio nasal. Aunt, aunt, aunt. Practica, aunt. Julio?
Yes.
Yes, practica, si lo digo, lo practicas. Aunt.
Aunt.
Aunt, sí. Aunt. Una pequeña T al final, aunt.
Aunt.
Aunt. Yes. Una palabra parecida que es... Ant, hormiga. Ant, aunt. ¿Sí escuchan la diferencia? Ant, hormiga. Aunt, tía.
Sí.
Yes. Okay. Ant, aunt. It's different. In case you see ant, do not confuse these words. It's just one letter. What letter is that? It's letter U. Aunt, aunt. Easy. Okay, we have another exercise here. We have some adjectives like kind, responsible. You need to repeat. Okay, kind, responsible. Yes, are you doing it? Sí están repitiendo, ¿verdad?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, I believe you. Polite. Nervous. Nervous. Lazy. 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 Rude. Rude.
Room.
Yes. Rude es, no es rudo, es grosero. Rude. Rape. Okay, let's see. Christian, can you read all the adjectives, please?
Can't.
Okay, lo acabo de leer. Lo acabo de leer.
Ya lo olvidé, teacher.
Kind.
Responsible.
Okay, lo leo one more time, please. Lo voy a leer otra vez.
Please.
Kind, responsible, polite, polite, nervous, lazy, rude, brave.
Okay. Brave.
Okay, now you, Christian.
Okay. Kind, responsible, polite, nervous, lazy, rude, brave.
Yes, it is responsible, responsible, here, responsible.
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 Yeah, responsible.
Responsible.
Responsible. Aquí dice sible, ¿verdad? Dice sible. Sable. Sable. Responsible.
Responsible.
Yeah. Responsible. Polite. And this is nervous. Nervous. Entre all you, nervous. Nervous.
Nervous.
Okay, Ruby, can you read it, please? Can you read the adjectives?
Responsible. Casi no los alcanzo a ver, teacher.
Okay.
Y es que me conecto del teléfono.
Oh, entra en la pantalla. Okay, let me show this. Hold on. Okay. Go ahead. Ruby, continue, please.
Okay, responsible, polite, nervous, lazy, rude, brave. Este sí no lo.
Yes, except the one. Number one is kind.
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 Polite, nervous, lazy, rude, and brave. Miriam, brave. Please. Thank you. Miriam?
Sí. Es kind, responsible, polite, nervous, lazy, rude, y brave.
All right, good. Thank you. Estefania?
Is kind, responsible, polite, lazy, rude, brave and nervous.
Oh, good. Julio?
Kind. Kind, no?
Yes.
Responsible, polite, nervous, lazy, rude, brave.
Yes. All right, just pay attention on the responsible. 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 Yes? Julio?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, yes, practica. Can I want to hear you. ¿Quieres escucharte? Responsible. Responsible.
Responsible.
Okay, practice, practice, practice. Okay, we have one question here. Write four more questions to ask your partner about his or her family, then ask an answer. You have a question. What's your father like? He's very outgoing. In the last lesson, we were learning, besides this, espero que se acuerden, we were learning, for example, interesting. ¿Se acuerdan? Nice. Easygoing. Outgoing. Ayúdenme, help me please. What else?
Funny.
Nice.
Funny.
Say one more time, Ruby.
Nice.
Nice. Yeah, you have nice here. We have friendly. What else?
Intelligent.
Yeah, we have intelligent.
Smart. Quiet.
Smart.
Shy.
Quiet. Intelligent. Shy. Yes. What else? What else?
Esther.
Happy, right? We can say introvert or extrovert.
Fun.
Yeah, fun.
Lazy.
Lazy. Talkative. Talkative is when you talk too much. Que nunca paras de hablar, ¿verdad? Talkative. Talkative. Okay, practice these questions, please. What's your father, for example? What's your mom like? Let me put it over here. What's your mom like? And then you can say, she is blah, 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 blah. Right? Ya con el blah, 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 ya me entiende, ¿verdad? Lo que sigue. Same. What's your brother like? What's your boyfriend like? You can ask anybody in the family. Well, your boyfriend is not your family yet, but you can make questions like that. Okay, please do it in Teams. Hold on. Okay, go ahead, please.
Julio.
Hey, estaba hablando, digo, bueno, ya me sacó, no sé dónde ande.
No, es que te saliste, ¿no?
Teacher.
Yes, Estefanía.
Tengo una pequeña duda. En las preguntas, en el grammar, en he, she, it, cuando se pregunta who's this, se contesta it's my grandmother. Ya no se le da el de ella o el de él.
Si te preguntan who's this, se puede contestar con it. Pero si te preguntan who's she, ¿quién es ella? Ya está siendo más específica, ¿verdad? She's my grandma. Entonces te pregunto, who's this? Es diferente, el sujeto.
Okay.
Si te pregunto yo con who's she o who's he, tienes que mencionar she o he, ¿verdad? Pero si la pregunta es abierta, es decir, who's this? Es como decir, ¿quién es este? It's my grandma, it's my grandpa, or it's my brother. ¿Yes?
¿Y no es correcto contestar con el her o el his?
No. Esos son posesivos. Por ejemplo, what's your brother's name? You can answer with it. Supongamos que tienes un hermano que se llama Julio. Right?
Okay.
Ese hermano con what's your brother's name? I am asking you with what. You can say it's Julio. You can say his name is Julio, or you can say Julio. You have different options. Pero aquí, como estamos viendo lo que es el libro, lo correcto es contestar con it's. Pero ya en una conversación normal, ¿cómo que se llama? Julio. His name is Julio. Yes.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
Hay varias formas de contestar, nada más que estamos viendo como vamos, nos estamos enfocando en lo que está el libro. Pero ya en una conversación normal, si te preguntan, estamos diciendo el nombre. Oh, his name is Julio. So easy.
Okay.
Any other questions? Pregunten. Las preguntas son gratis, están en oferta, 2x1. Déjenme enderezo mi foto porque ya me cansé. Digo, estoy así, ¿verdad? Ok, homework.
Okay.
Did you do your homework? ¿Cómo van con las tareas?
Ahí vamos, dice, ya se las voy a mandar. Ya las estoy terminando.
Recuerden que cada tema que estamos viendo, ya estamos en la unidad 3. Las tareas es para reforzar todo lo que estamos viendo y lo practiquen. Entonces, necesito mandármela. Ya esta semana tenemos probablemente... No, yo creo que el examen va a ser el lunes. Entonces, aquí el lunes ya tienen que tener todas sus tareas. ¿Por qué? Porque el tareas dijimos que era el 20%, ¿verdad?
Okay, teacher.
It's important you send it to me to my number. Saying, cualquier pregunta que ustedes tengan o no van a estar en clase, lo que sea mi número, no al grupo. ¿Ok?
Okay, teacher.
The same with attendance and punctuality. Recuerden que la tolerancia es de 10 minutos solamente.
Sí, es que yo no tenía internet, por eso tardé en contestar, en conectarme hoy.
Yo no he dicho nada, mira que...
No, pero le digo porque no la... Le digo porque no la había dicho. Es que no me podía conectar, no me dejaba.
Sí, vi que mandaste un mensaje, pero lo borraste.
Es que pensé que estaba fallando. Eso le iba a decir, pero digo, creo que ya, hasta que ella. Me pude conectar.
No, está bien. Mientras me avisen, está bien de que van a llegar tarde o algo, ¿ok? Pero son 10 minutos. Supongamos la clase empieza a las 6. A las 10 yo ya empiezo a pasar lista, como quien dice.
Teacher, yo por ejemplo no tengo su número. Es que bueno, yo las clases desde el principio no estuve. Apenas me agregaron la semana pasada.
Ah, ¿no estás en el grupo de WhatsApp?
Estoy, pero nada más me mandaron las cosas que ya habían enviado. No me mandaron su número ni nada de eso. Bueno, nada más.
A ver, yo creo que te tengo, ¿no? A ver, déjame ver.
Sí.
¿No?
En el grupo, tal vez sí.
¿Cuál es tu número? A ver, aquí tengo dos números que no conozco.
5579131524. Ese es mi número.
Ok, Gare, ¿ya te mandé un mensaje?
Ya, listo.
All right. Ruby, got my number. Cristian, Julio, Estefanía, what about you? Yes? You sent me some messages before.
Sí, yo le mandé mensajes apenas.
Yeah. You sent me your homework too.
Yes.
Okay. Let's see, questions.
No, teacher.
Okay, let's continue here. We are almost done. We almost finished. Okay, just a couple questions for each one. All right, Julio, what's your favorite color? Mr. Julio Cortez, black. What's your favorite color?
Black, teacher.
Black? Okay.
Yes.
Nice, I like black too. All right, how old are you? How old are you?
¿Me sigue preguntando a mí?
Yeah, yeah. How old are you?
Good.
Remember, that's why I ask you, how old are you? Es muy parecido. How are you? So yes.
Yes.
How old are you? Julio, how old are you?
23.
So, ¿cómo se contesta?
I am 23 years old.
Yes,
22.
Oh, 22.
Yes.
Years old. Remember to use the complete form. I am 22 years old. Okay. How are you doing? Julio?
Very good.
How are you doing? Remember, this is informal way to say, how are you? Remember the first class? How are you doing? Si te pregunta alguien, how are you doing, Julio? I'm okay. I'm good. I'm fine. So-so. Not too bad. Hay muchas formas de contestar. Recuerda, how are you doing is informal. Es informal. El formal es how are you. I hope you remember all this from lesson, first lesson. All right, let's see, Estefania. Estefania, do you have siblings?
Excuse me?
Do you have siblings?
I don't know. Mean siblings.
You don't know? Ay, pensé que no sabes si tenías hermanos o no. Okay. Siblings is general for brothers and sisters. Yes?
Okay. Yes.
For example, you can say, I have six siblings. I have four sisters. And two brothers. Cuando hablamos de siblings, es general, no se especifica el género, el sexo. Cuando ya hablamos de sisters, quiere decir hermanas, ¿verdad? Hermanos. So siblings es general.
Okay.
The same when you say parents, right? Parents is general. So you say mom, and you say dad. Yes. So, Estefania y Miriam, you need to review unit one. Well, all of you, 1, 2, and 3, because you are having a test. Todo lo de las unidades viene en el examen.
Okay.
Lo principal. So, traten de ponerse al corriente con todos los temas, como por ejemplo nickname. Miriam, do you have a nickname?
No, es que yo la verdad no soy nada al corriente. De hecho, le quería preguntar por mensaje que si me podía dar los temas para poder estudiarlos.
Bueno, les recomiendo a si van atrasadas que pidan a la escuela. Como estudiantes tienen derecho a pedir una clase, revisión de las unidades que nos vieron. ¿Yes?
De hecho, sí me dieron dos clases, pero la verdad es que no vimos hasta el nivel que ustedes están, no. De hecho, yo pedí otra clase porque las clases que perdí fueron pues muchas. Perdí la semana pasada y parte de esta. Ajá. Entonces, yo pedí las clases, únicamente me dieron dos, pero pues no fue suficiente. Pedí otra, pero están pendientes, que la verdad yo creo que no me la van a dar porque si no ya me hubieran dicho. Entonces yo voy a estudiar por mi cuenta.
Ya, yeah, lo que puedes hacer es, todos los temas los encuentras en el Cambridge Platform. ¿Ya tienes tu username y tu código?
Ya.
Yeah. Ok, vete al Cambridge Platform, te vas al libro 1 y te vas a la unidad 1, 2 y 3. No necesitas a alguien que te...
Que me explique.
Es lo mismo, o te va guiando paso a paso en un sistema.
Ok.
Entonces, bien fácil. Espero que todos sepan ya cómo se usa el Cambridge Platform. Recuerden, unidad 1, 2 y 3. Vienen ejercicios, actividades, vienen juegos, vienen videos y viene el libro. ¿Ok?
Sí, eso sí me lo explicaron.
So, para que, so you can be updated, you know, with the lessons. Unit 1, 2, and 3, you have to do that. It's easier on the platform. Christian, you have your username and password?
Yes.
Cambridge platform?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
What about you?
Teacher, una pregunta.
Yes.
Por ejemplo, es que el otro día yo estaba viendo la plataforma de Cambridge y estuve contestando algunos ejercicios. Ahora, mi pregunta es, si tenemos alguna duda de respecto a la plataforma, pero no en cuestión de uso, en cuestión del tema, ¿podemos mandarle captura y hacerle la pregunta por WhatsApp?
Sí, claro. Mientras le tomen una foto, un screenshot, ya me lo mandan.
Ah, okay.
I will tell you whatever you need, just let me know. Make questions if you don't understand anything or something, but you need to ask.
Okay, thank you.
Well, guys, that's all for today. We will continue tomorrow, same time. Please be on time, be here, okay?
Okay,
thank you very much. Have a wonderful night. Thank you.
See you, teacher.
See you. Bye-bye.